Another really important function of cell membranes is something called signal transduction. And this is when molecules outside of the cell trigger a response inside of the cell. However, no molecules actually move across the cell membrane. I always sort of think of signal transduction as when I ask my daughter to go get her brother for dinner, and she stands right next to me and yells as loud as she can, "Hey, Alex, it's time to come eat." She didn't move anywhere, but she communicated something. So this is going to use embedded proteins to connect signal molecules from the outside with responding molecules inside. And I think it's easiest to see this in a visual. So here we have our lipid bilayer, and we have an embedded protein. And then we've got a molecule, maybe testosterone, that's going to attach to embedded protein. And when it attaches here, it changes the physical shape of this protein, which releases this little green protein. That green protein attaches to this blue one, which causes it to split apart into these two. And we get this whole cascade of reactions that eventually reach the nucleus and cause the nucleus to do something. Could be that it stops making certain proteins, could mean that it starts making proteins. So imagine this is a chin cell on a 13-year-old boy. This lands here. We get a signal transduction pathway that causes this cell to start growing hairs, and that individual is going to start growing a beard. Especially hormones use this signal transduction pathway. So it's a great sort of chemical signal from the outside of the cell to get the inside of the cell to start doing something. This is also a key way that many medicines work on cells. You could imagine you could develop your own chemical that fits in and stimulates the action of a signal transduction pathway. Or, if the signal transduction pathway is working too much, you can develop a drug that fits in here and blocks this so that the hormones or the other proteins produced by the body can't get to this, can't trigger it, and we stop the pathway. About 60% of medications work this way. A final topic related to cell membranes is that the cell membrane is the gateway for everything that goes in and out of the cell. And at some point, the cell membrane becomes a limiting factor to how big the cell can get. If you've got a small, normal-sized classroom, two doors is plenty. You can move students in and out. But if we had a classroom of 1,000 people and we only had two doors, it would take a long time to get everyone in and out. And you would either want to add more doors or split that big classroom into many small classrooms. And it's the same idea here with cell membranes. As a cell gets bigger, the volume inside increases much faster than the surface area. And as a result, if the cell gets too big, the cell membrane surface area just can't efficiently help that cell maintain homeostasis. What this leads to is if you're going to be the size of a human being, it's better to be made of many, many small cells instead of a few large cells. Organisms that are single-celled are all microscopic because you just can't efficiently maintain homeostasis with a single cell membrane of a very, very large cell.